We are here at Chippewa Valley High School in Clinton Township with Ron Roberts, our superintendent of schools, Chris, our instructor here in the weight room, and Mackenzie, one of our students. And we are here to talk about this blood drive. The 2020 blood drive will be the 21st annual blood drive for I think the entire length of time, because this of course predates me. Chippewa Valley's been involved in this blood drive. You've been one of our site sponsors. The blood drive will take place on February 4th and 5th, but on February 4th from 1 to 7, right here at Chippewa Valley, you can donate a pint of blood to participate in one of the biggest blood drives that we have in this in all of Southeast Michigan. So Ron, tell us why Chippewa Valley is involved.
Yeah, first I'd like to say we're really proud of the fact that we're working with the township. We see it as a community event. It's important to us, as I know it's important to you as a township official. It's also important to our community because blood's so important that we have a good supply of it. But as you mentioned, this is our 21st year in 2020. And to us, it's really fits well with what we do in our schools because we have kids from our Medical Careers Academy, which is an important program in our CTE department. Career and Technical Education. These students work in hospitals. The kids in Clinton Township at Chippewa Valley High School work at McLaren Hospital in Mount Clemens. And so they come in and they volunteer and they have a lot to do with the drive. So we really see it as beneficial to our students who are pursuing medicine as careers. We also have a lot of staff members who participate and help with the coordination of the event in our school. So we're really happy with what we can do to support Clinton Township and our residents.
So a benefit all around because you're engaging your staff, you're engaging these students, providing opportunity for them to sort of get some hands-on experience. Yeah. and actually the delivery of healthcare,
right.
Collection of blood.
Right, and you think of our students who are pursuing medical careers that get to come in and work with the community and help them go through the process of delivering or giving blood. And so that's really good for our students, and it's good for the people who will receive that blood at some time in the future.
So here's the real value, though, I think, with this blood drive and the school's involvement. They do the statistics on this. And this blood drive, of course, it's in February. There's always a challenge. There's always a weather challenge, school closures, things of that nature. But we have the highest percentage of new donors. And so when people donate for the first time, you remove the mystique and sort of maybe some of the apprehension about donating blood, and then people become regular donors once they've donated once. And so that is probably the best benefit of this blood drive and the school's involvement in it.
So really then anyone that's out there who's thinking about giving blood, it'd be their first time. It's such a comfortable surroundings in which to give it right here in our schools. And they are greeted and taken through the process, not only by trained professionals from the medical field, but also our students, which I think is a real benefit for those people to get to come in here and meet our students.
I think that's great. So our theme this year is we've got the power to save lives and pump up the blood supply. So we kind of have this bright, splashy 80s colored theme. And one of the things about the 80s is it kicked off the health craze. So we're here in the weight room. We're here with Chris and we're here with Mackenzie, teacher, student. Tell us about this class and what the objectives are and what happens here and what you're trying to deliver to students.
All right, Chris.
Okay, well, we're just trying to teach them how to have a healthy lifestyle as they graduate from Chippewa so they can kind of know what it means to have a healthy body, build yourself some self-confidence, know what strong muscles equals strong heart, and prevents injuries later in life, because if you're used to working out, you're going to have a better health later on in life.
Well, I wanted to better myself and be able to have self-confidence in my body and how I feel about myself. And later on down the road for my future, I want to be able to be strong and do my job that I want to do and just support others and also be an example for others to work out and get in the gym and do better for themselves.
So healthy community members means people who have the ability to then donate blood to help. There's all kinds of advancements in medical technology, but the one thing that cannot be done in a laboratory is make blood. We need people for that, and that's why this event is important. So, and this is what I like to say, we got Chris here, who's a big guy. He comes across the burning building, no doubt he could run in and drag somebody to safety and save a life, but it doesn't just take that. It takes people like Mackenzie here who can also donate a pint of blood and save three lives. So I'm sure you guys would be willing to do either one of those things, right?
Of course.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you, Ron, Chris, Mackenzie, for being here. And we want to encourage people to come on out, help us. February 4th, right here at Chippewa Valley High School, from 1 o'clock to 7 o'clock. And we're going to put this up on the screen, but call 286-1768 or go to redcrossblood.org. And the sponsor code is Clinton Township. That's the way to sign up and reserve your spot here at Chippewa Valley.
And not only will you feel good about helping others by donating blood, but you will meet some amazing students from the Chippewa Valley Schools and Clinton Township. And you're going to want to do that. We have great kids. Come in and meet them.
Sounds great. Thank you, everyone. Appreciate you participating in this.